Welcome back to another session of Character Modeling with me, S'more, aka Steve Moore. And the number of subscribers has been ticking up. I really appreciate that, everybody that subscribes and likes these videos. Muchas gracias. And let's get on with it. Okay, so in the last session, we went through the process of making some real time hair using XGen, and we'd focused on the short hair. So that was relatively easy. This week we're going to step it up a notch, and we're going to make some longer hair, and we're going to style it a little bit, you know. And I'm going to use an alternate method, slightly different method, for capturing the hair cards themselves out of XGen. So we had grabbed the primitives and just converted those to hair cards. We're going to try using the camera facing option for this one. And the advantage of that is we're going to get the normals from you know, directly from that option there. All right. So right now I'll turn off my guide head for a second. And so to make the long hair, I took this shell here and I have broken it up into smaller chunks. Now the idea here is that we want to mimic the way that the hair grows naturally, right? So we started with the short hair at the base, and now we're going to work our way up towards the part line, you know. So, you know, these shells represent different layers of hair. So we're going to have this kind of hair growing. We're going to focus in on this area here, and that's going to kind of grow over the top of the shorter hair that we've already made. And ultimately, we would make the, you know, the part line, you know, from this particular area, and it would grow over that area, right? So that makes sense. So you're kind of trying to build the hair up in layers as it would occur naturally. So I'm using geometry. So for XGen, you need some geometry to extrude the hair from, to generate the hair. You can actually make a complete hair shell and apply UV coordinates and use masks, so that is an option. I just went for kind of creating subdividing my shell into the various clumps that I would need. So I made geometry. That's just the way I rolled. So with that, let's get into it, and we will hide all this other stuff and focus in on this little bit here. And as you may recall, I have this geometry that is my, it's going to serve as my guide for how I want to style the hair. And we want to make kind of an area part of this big kind of bang that's coming down, that's framing her face here. So we're going to focus in on this front area here. Okay, let's make some hair. Grabbing our little hair shell, activate XGen. Create new description, and this time I'm going to give it a quick name. We'll call this long mid, left, and then I'll copy that name over to the collection. All right, so we want to use splines for the primitives. Under the generate, we're going to use randomly across surface. That's the primitives, and we're going to control the primitives by placing and shaping guides. So splines, randomly across surface, placing and shaping guides, and hit create. Okay, we are now in XGen. The first thing I'm going to do is check my renderer set to viewport 2.0. The others will work, but viewport 2.0 gives you a better kind of preview of the anisotropic shader here. So up here we have sculpt guides and we have add or move guides, right? So let's add a guide, and I'm just going to add a couple for now, just these four. Don't need too many. We can duplicate and we can move them later. So less is more in the situation because it's going to be easier to control a few, right? Okay, so if we activate the preview, we see this is what we get. They're focused over here and kind of dissipating away from the guides. That's cool. We can turn off. I'm going to just go down here and turn off tube shading, and we'll dial up the density a little bit. Let's say 5 cube. Okay, so these aren't very long. All right, so Q key will enable us. I'm going to hide the primitives. The Q key will enable us to select all our primitives. FYI, that would be let's see, Windows UI toolbox. My toolbox kind of doesn't like to play nicely, but that's our little select button right there. Okay, so with the primitives selected, or the guides selected, my bad, the guides are selected. Under the primitives, we're going to go down to set length, right? And I'm going to dial this up to, oh, let's say 25. And there we go. Now we've got something we can work with. Alrighty. And also, as you may recall, I have in this scene, I have a guide here on my layer, right? So I can, so we're focusing on this front bang here. The top of the bang is going to be a separate description. So we're going to layer it. So we've already got short here underneath, and we're going to layer this kind of long bang kind of coming from the midway upper scalp here. So we'll turn that back off. That's the goal anyway. Cool. So with that, we now want to turn to our sculpt guide brush, and actually the brush is a little hard to see, so I'm going to change my background color a little lighter. There you go. So now you can see the guide, the brush, and we can grab these guys and pull them down. Pretty good at figuring out which one you're trying to select, so that's nice. I'll turn my guide here on again for a minute, and let's bring them in there. Now you'll notice my guides are a little bit janky. They're a little bit kind of faceted, that's easy enough to fix. So right above set length, excuse me, we have rebuild. All right, so our CV count is currently 5. Let's dial it up. Let's try, I don't know, maybe 8. Wouldn't be too crazy. There you go. Okay, so now they're a little smoother. Very nice, very nice. That's cool. And we can just start tuning those a little better. Turn this off to the side here. Sometimes it helps just to select an individual strand. Sculpt guides. Now, obviously, you'd probably want to make turn, assign hotkeys, your own preferences as far as hotkeys. I for these demos, I'm lazy, so I tend to kind of delay assigning hotkeys. And B, I think it helps for the demo to kind of see where these brushes are. So that's why I kind of tend to go the long route, as opposed to having on a whole bunch of convenient hotkeys. That's my excuse anyway. So sculpt guides brush, and we just, oopsie, pull you around there. There you go, sweetie. Yeah, starting to get there. And just do the same with these guys, and I want to kind of bring them all to the kind of approximately the same point in space, right? So that the guides Q key sculpt guides brush, and we're getting there. Yeah. Okay, so if I pull over the X Gen window again, and we're gonna hit the update X-Gen preview, and you get an idea. Yeah, now it's starting to look like here, right? FYI, if you see something like this, it means you're probably in the default legacy renderer, so just go up to viewport 2.0. I'm way back into Maya 2017 right now. So if you're using a later version, you may not have that option. Anywho, maybe keeps things simpler. So I'm just gonna so remember that the Xgen does not update automatically, so you kind of have to, so if you want to see what the effect is, so that makes it a little tedious at the moment, but no doubt things will improve with time. So we can turn off those guides, turn them on. But that's starting to look like something, right? I like that. Okay, so a little earlier I mentioned that less is more when it comes to these guides. So supposing I'd like to flesh this out a little bit more, what we can do at this point with the Q key, select one of these guides, go up here to your add or move guides button and activate it. And now with this guide selected, if we click over here, it's going to essentially copy that guide. Q, okay, I'm going to select that one. And maybe I want to flesh this little area out here. And let's copy it over here. But maybe I want to move it a little bit, so control key down, and you can move it around. So you get kind of the effect you want. Yeah, cool. And maybe I don't really want that one over there, so I'll just hit it and delete it. And Bob's your auntie. You're still getting some hair strands over here because it's just kind of, it's just dissipating from around the primitives. Okay, so let's say, I'm reasonably happy with that. And now we need to take our primitives here and turn them into hair cards. So similar to last week where we did the short hair, but we're going to do a little bit of a variation. So last week when we captured our hair cards, we turned off face camera, and we grabbed the hair cards kind of in a static position in space. So this time we're going to actually leave face camera on, and what that's going to do is it's going to give us the normals based on the camera, as opposed to combing the normals, later. So here we go. First thing we need to craft some cards from our primitives here. So right now they're very thin, right? I will start by dialing the density down. So let's say like 0.5. And okay, so now it looks pretty sparse. And something more realistic. Once when you've got a whole head of hair, obviously you can't have too many cards because it's going to get super expensive. So we're going to make them nice and thick and utilize an alpha channel, right? So under the width, so primitives, and right under length you find width. Let's dial that up to 2. There you go. So now we have some hair cards, or something approximating what we want for hair cards, and they're facing the camera. So no matter which way I turn the object, they always appear to be the same width because they're always facing the camera. Okay, so the tr so with this approach, bearing in mind that the results will be facing the camera, you want to position the hair cards, kind of where you expect them to kind of, the average, where you want the average angle of the hair cards to be. So that takes a little bit of kind of trial and error, a bit of artistic judgment there. So I'm going to say kind of about side on for this clump. Right, so now once we've got our hair cards set up the way we want them, we're going to go up to this tool here called Select Primitives. You may remember that from the last session. Activate that and drag a box around all our primitives, and they turn green like the Hulk, meaning they're active. Okay, I'm going to drag that window out of the way for a minute. Now, holding the space bar down to get your kind of main marking menu, if you look down here, you'll find this generate menu. And if we go down to here, you see convert XGen primitives to polygons. Select that, and you get this option box. Now, you might recall this from the last session when we were making shorter here. We'll leave convert selected primitives on, and combine mesh, meaning we're just going to get one mesh for all the hair cards. If you turn it off, you get individual meshes, which you know you may want. Placing UV tiles. This time we're going to leave this on, and as you know, you may have figured out that means it's going to make a tile. So it's going to make a page of UV tiles and randomly assign different cards to different tiles. So that's nice. So we can get some variety in our hair. We don't have to have just one texture or have to manually assign them. So I'm going to leave that on and click convert. And there we go. So right now we have both the XGen and the polygons in the same view. So we'll go down to the outliner, pull the outliner up here, and this little button here, this is our XGen. I'll hide the primitives for a sec, the polygons. This is our XGen kind of collection, and we can hide that and then turn back on the polygon. So now we're just looking at our final hair cards, right? And you'll see that they're nice and soft looking, right? So we've got the normals based on the camera, and they're nice and averaged out. So that's great. So we'll get some nice soft fluffy hair. We don't have to comb it like the previous example. All right, let's take a look at our UVs here. So I'll grab my hair cards, and I'm going to assign a little color guide that I created for the purposes, the demo purposes here, so that you can see the XGen has randomly assigned the different cards to various quadrants in the 0 to 1 space that it has created, right? So, you know, here we've got a little UV shell, stack of UV shells there. That you can see it's separate. And you'll also notice I've darkened the roots. I put a little gradient on my texture guide so you can see that all the roots, all the cards are consistently orientated with the roots at the bottom of the page and the tips down here at the top of the page. So if I, for example, just grab the UVs along the bottom of the page here, you'll see that they show up at the roots. And that is very important. The reason for that is that we're going to apply what's called an anisotropic shader for the hair when we get this in a game engine, right? And the anisotropic shader is going to create a long streaky highlight that is going to be based on the orientation of the UVs. So that is why it's very important that your UVs be orientated consistently, roots at the bottom, you know, tips at the top, and then our little anisotropic highlight will travel in a consistent direction across our hair. So there you go. All right, so finally, I just wanted to show you guys, I've made a quick test. Well, I wouldn't say quick. I made a test hair page. This is basically the kind of the final hair texture page I used for my Shiyun model with a slightly different color on it. And so you can see kind of the results. You start to see the results anyway. So it's starting to look like hair, because you have, you know, not just one little texture, but multiple ones randomly assigned, and XGen is taking care of that for us along with the normals. So fantastic, you know, we're getting there. So this is going to live on top of the short here that we created last week, and I would, you know, ultimately I would finish up, you know, with layering some hair on top of this to create the part, etc. Next session, we'll look at making the textures for the hair cards using fiber mesh and ZBrush. And I think in the future, in the coming months, I'm planning to do some new videos, kind of break away from the series a little bit and do some new characters. Anywho, if you'd like to get hold of the model featured in this video series, please check out my new Gumroad page. Also, you could kind of help support the channel if you like the videos and whatnot. It's pretty modest right now, but I do have one package available for download, which features the high-res ZBrush model, the Marvelous Designer files, Marmoset scene, avatars, all that good stuff. That's all for this session. So until next time, happy modeling. Ciao. That's